One of two women accusing Virginia's Democratic lieutenant governor of sexual assaults is speaking out, graphically describing her alleged attack to CBS News.
I honestly didn't know what was going on. And then the next thing I know, like, my head is like literally in his crotch, and I'm choking and gagging. And, you know, I couldn't say anything because I'm choking and gagging. And so, you know, it continues for, and it's holding my head. So I can't lift, like, I'm trying to lift my head, but I can't.
The Democrat, Justin Fairfax, maintains his innocence. There is a second accuser as well. Fairfax says both encounters in question were consensual and that he has passed polygraph tests. So how do Democrats now handle the claims against one, a longtime party veteran, and the other, a rising star? Joining me now, the former press secretary for the Democratic Policy and Communications Committee, Rochelle Ritchie, and Fox News contributor Katie Pavlich. Welcome to you both.
Hi, Shannon.
Hi, Shannon.
Okay, so I want to go back to the Biden case because a lot has been made about the fact that he said, I don't remember things this way. We must listen to these women. It's valid to hear them out. But it was never my intention to cause anyone to be uncomfortable. The Washington Post writing this, saying, when the Me Too movement really got off the ground, the party seemed to adopt an approach that said accusers should be believed, full stop. What was important was how the women involved interpreted the events. Rochelle?
Well, you know, Shannon, I think that, you know, as a sexual assault survivor, I can tell you that I do not like to see us politicize sexual assault. And I think that we need to make sure that we're not doing that. This is not a partisan issue. This is a bipartisan issue that we should be addressing on both sides. And it leads to a bigger conversation as to why are men so ignorant to how their behavior or how they approach women makes them feel uncomfortable. And I think we have to start to expand that conversation and really educate men on how they behave. And at some point, you can't just say, that's how I am. Just being that way is not okay. You have to look in the mirror and say, well, if everyone is saying this, maybe I am the problem, and maybe I need to address, you know, my behavior and my actions.
Yeah, and Lucy Flores, the one who said that the vice president smelled her hair and was too close to her and made her feel uncomfortable, she said if he doesn't realize he was doing something wrong, that in itself is inappropriate.
Right.
But there are many people out there, you've seen, as Trace reported, a lot of high-profile defenders saying, listen, this is just the kind of guy he is. He's always been this way. Here's right. what Joy Behar said on The View.
That's what he's like. And I feel it would be really unfortunate if we got rid of everybody who was just an affectionate kind of person. Those are nice people, too.
So, Katie, where are Democrats going to have to find this line that you can't cross?
Well, I agree with Rochelle that the weaponization of sexual assault, or in this case, sexual misconduct or inappropriate touching, as they're saying, is a problem because it muddies the waters when it comes to justice for actual victims. For Democrats, they're the ones who put themselves in this situation. For decades, they defended Bill Clinton against a number of sexual assault claims. They dragged women's reputations who accused him of those crimes through the mud, and they destroyed their lives. So they've been defending this kind of behavior at a very high level for years. And now that they're having this Me Too movement, they're grappling with the idea that there's somehow a spectrum of inappropriate behavior. And it seems like for the left, consequences for misconduct and inappropriate touching or behavior depends on whether you are a Democrat or a Republican. There's a lot more evidence against Joe Biden acting inappropriately with women than there is or was against Judge Brett Kavanaugh, and yet they did everything that they could to destroy his life, his family's life, with nothing to show for it. And so I think they need to rethink this talking point about, well, he's just that way, and I'm not willing to indict all men because Joe Biden has a problem with not touching people inappropriately.
All right, I want to read a couple of Alyssa Milano tweets, who's been very outspoken advocate, shared her own assault story, and this has been very personal for her. But this is what she tweets about the latest accusation against the vice president. She says, I respect Lucy Flores' decision to share her story and agree with Biden that we all must pay attention to it. But just as we must believe women that decide to come forward, we cannot assume all women's experiences are the same. Now, back in September, this is what she said about Dr. Christine Blasey Ford, the accuser against Justice Kavanaugh. I'm proud to support Dr. Christine Blasey Ford's brave decision to tell her story. those who speak painful truth must be supported in every way. Quickly, 15-second reaction from both of you. Rochelle, we'll start with you to the contrast.
Well, Shannon, you know, obviously you can see the hypocrisy in those statements. You know, even though I am an independent and I do not, you know, want to be a hypocrite at all. And I think that while it, you know, it's important to listen to women, it's important to hear their allegations. But at the same time, there have been stories of women that have lied about sexual assault. Here in New York, there was a girl that was just sentenced to a year in jail for lying about two African-American college athletes raping her. And she made up the entire thing. So if we're going to talk about believing victims, then we also have to give the accused their day in court as well.
Yeah. Yep. I think we all agree that due process is one of the bedrock foundations of this country, and Katie, something that we all deserve.
Yeah, I completely agree with everything Rochelle just said, and we should be taking women seriously, but we should not be stripping men of their due process rights just because women make allegations.
We all got to be consistent.
And I wish Hollywood would take that message too.
Yeah.
Because Alyssa Milano said a lot of things about Brett Kavanaugh that were not true.
We all have to be consistent. Yes. I think that's fair. All right, Rochelle and Katie, stick around. Good to have you. We'll have you back for another Hot Topic in just a minute.
Great.